here we go then. 5 minutes of this pivotal practice session remaining here in Kota. And it's all eyes on the world champion, Bagnaia in 12th place. Jack Miller as well, who had a pretty impressive morning session. He's in 14th spot. Quartararo, 16th. Brad Binder as well, down in 20th. Binder needs a couple of real big laps, doesn't he, on the factory KTM at the moment. Both factory KTMs not where they need to be and not where they want to be.
And they're holding Brad Binder back at the moment. He's still in the pits. In fact, he's just left the pits as we speak to you. So he's going out on the racetrack. So Brad Binder will be up against it. It will be touch and go for the South African to get round for two flying laps. Fabio Quartararo, who was out of sequence, who just came back into the pits, he's still in the pits at the moment. So Quartararo staring at one more flying lap.
Costa was really anxious there to go with Bagnaia, get a reference behind the double MotoGP world champion. He passed him so brilliantly, didn't he, a couple of times in that Portuguese Grand Prix 3 weeks ago. We're on board then with Acosta on the Red Bull Gas Tech 3 machine. He's looking directly ahead to Bagnaia, a sight that he was familiar with in Portimao before he dispensed with the world champion with relative ease, you have to say. Also trying to go in this freight train is Mir on the 36.
Half the field.
Repsol Honda. Yeah, there's a big gang here. Big freight train behind Bagnaia. That was Alex Marquez, wasn't it? Just ahead of him as they dip under the observation tower here in Kota.
Yeah, Quartararo has now left the pit. So all 22 riders are now out on circuit. And it looks like about a third of them are on the rear wheel of Pecco Bagnaia. Alex Marquez, who was just ahead of this train, has just dropped in behind Bagnaia, which won't please Acosta, who is going to have to follow Alex Marquez out of this final corner. So on to the start-finish straight we come. The penultimate lap for all these guys. And it's a crucial one for the reigning world champion.
Yeah, they know Bagnaia can't back out of this to try and get clear traffic, so he's got to get his head down. 5.5 kilometers left, and Acosta on the inside of Alex Marquez, and once again that gas machine snaking around underneath him in the heartbreaking zone for turn one. You can just see how desperate he is to go with Bagnaia. Excellent first half of his final lap, potentially coming for Maverick Vinales. He is up on Martin by just over half a tenth. Vinales with his eyes on maybe an all-time lap record here in Kota.
Personal best two for Fabio Di Gianantonio. Personal best through the first sector for just about everybody in this train. Bagnaia a tenth of a second off. So too is Acosta. So that overtake on Alex Marquez didn't slow down Acosta too much. And we know how quick that KTM is down the back straight. He might be giving Pecco Bagnaia one or two headaches on this back straight in a moment.
Lost over a tenth in sector three, did Vinales. Off your camera right now, you can see his name on the graphic at the bottom of your screen. Still on course to move up from seventh to second place in the slipstream, nudging 350 kilometers an hour. Goes Acosta behind Bagnaia. This is Vinales then. This should be job done for the Spanish rider. Vulnerable in seventh place, but no longer vulnerable in second. That's much more like it. And that was a great lap by Vinales. He had a brilliant fourth sector once again. A 2:01.473 within striking distance of Martin, just under 800ths between the top two now.
He's been strong through that sector all day, hasn't he? Top gun, he was top through there once again. Oh, crash the background for Joan Mir. The yellow flags around as he kicks the front fairing, just showing what kind of mood he's in. The good news for Bagnaia, who was perhaps most at risk for those yellow flags, is that he's ahead of that incident. So Bagnaia will not be under any kind of threat here if he can get this lap time on the board. Half a second off through the third sector, that would still put him up inside the top three if he holds that, but Acosta's quicker behind him.
Into turn 20 we go, final corner. Bagnaia being hotly pursued by Acosta. Alex Marquez, Bagnaia delivers once again, as he so often does, up to P3, a 2:01.808. Surely that is job done. Safely advancing into Q2. He certainly thinks so because he's rolled out of it. Bagnaia with a sing on the dashboard, 2:01.808, and he will think, yeah, don't need to be pushing, taking any more risk. I'm going into Q2. Mission accomplished.
And the crafty Acosta right behind him, up into fourth place as well. So Pedro Acosta looks like he's safely through. We've had lap times cancelled elsewhere due to yellow flags, but it doesn't affect anyone in the top four. So Aleix Espargaró now down to fifth. Bastianini sixth. Gian Antonio seventh. Mark Marquez is not safe at the moment in eighth, a 2:02.3. He's only a tenth of a second ahead of that dotted line for Miguel Oliveira, in currently in P10, but Mark Marquez is trying to safeguard his spot in the top 10 on his final lap.
What about Quartararo? Two corners of his lap remaining. He drops that left leg down into turn 19 in that little hollow before you a short rise back uphill into the final corner, turn 20. He's going to get a line here for one more lap potentially, Fabio Quartararo. It'll be really, really close. He stays in 17th place. He's still 1.4 seconds away from the best pace. Another miserable day for the Japanese brands. Quartararo leading the challenge there, the bottom six. What about Marc Marquez? Late on here, eighth spot, going in pursuit of an eighth COTA Grand Prix success here, the Gresini Racing rider. He's got his younger brother Alex directly ahead of him on the 73 bike. Now they'll drop underneath the observation tower here in COTA. I think Marc Marquez is going to be safe in that eighth place. Checkered flag is out. In fact, it could get a whole lot better here for the number 93, potentially on course for a top three. Mouth-watering going into tomorrow's qualifying in the Tissot Sprint with Martin Vinales, Bagnaia Acosta and Marc Marquez looking like they're going to be inside the top five. That's exactly what we've seen. A late 2:01.806 does fire Marquez up into P3.
Marc Marquez into Q2. Alex Marquez is not. He takes the checkered flag in 12th. We're watching Brad Binder here. He's had a poor second sector. It's a one-man show for the Pirelli Mobility Group at the moment, and that one man is Pedro Acosta in 5th, Brad Binder 14th, Augusto Fernandez 15th, Jack Miller 16th, and it's going to take a big final sector here for Brad Binder to avoid a trip through qualifying 1. He's a second down at the third checkpoint. He needs to pull time back on Martin in the final sector, and that is a tall order.
He's got a Mullerless 4 split, no question. Are we seeing a scenario where both the factory KTMs are not in Q2, while Pedro Acosta is? Out of the final corner comes Binder. Over the line he goes, no. And he stays in 14th. Brad Binder 14th, Jack Miller 16th. Pedro Acosta fired in a 2:01.966. Binder 6 tenths back. Miller not far shy of a second behind Acosta. High fives all round down inside Pertamina Endura VR46 Racing, because good job that both the Gian Antonio and Bezzecchi have just about crept in to Q2. But the headlines will quite rightly go to one rider, one star, the World Championship leader, setting his stall out early here in COTA with a new all-time lap record on Friday afternoon. Sizzling in the spring sunshine, wasn't he, Jorge Martin? A 2:01.397, and he leads into Q2 tomorrow.